Let's say we are given a matrix, and in this matrix, each cell is either 0 or 1 or 2. Right. 0 means that the cell is empty. 1 means that the cell has a fresh orange, and 2 means that the cell contains a rotten orange. All right. Let's say we have a rotten orange here, and we have fresh orange here and fresh orange here. Then what will happen is that after 1 hour, this rotten orange will rot the nearby cell, right? So this is what will happen after 1 hour. Then after another 1 hour, now this orange has rotten, so this will rot this one also, right? So it is more like zombies, right? So once a person becomes a zombie, then he can create more zombies, right? If an orange has become rotten, then that orange will rot other nearby oranges also. So let's say we have a fresh orange here, we have a rotten orange here, and a fresh orange here, fresh orange here, fresh orange here, and here, right? So after 1 hour, the situation will be that this orange will rot. After 2 hours, even this will rot. After 3 hours, even this will rot. And after 4 hours, even this will rot, right? So we can say that after 4 hours, all of these oranges will rot, right? Let's take another example. Let's say we have a rotten orange here, and then we have fresh oranges here. Because all of these four cells where we have fresh orange are nearby cells. So after 1 hour, everything will rot. Right? So all of these four will rot. Right? Now let's say we have a situation like this. So we have 1, 1, 1, 2. Right? So if we have a matrix like this, then what will happen is that after 1 hour, this orange will rot the nearby orange. This orange will rot the nearby orange, right? So after 1 hour, the matrix will look something like this. Then after 2 hours, even the other one will rot. So this is after 1 hour, and this is after 2 hours, right? So we can say that after 2 hours, the entire matrix will rot. All right? I think this is the question, right? So 0 represents an empty cell, 1 represents a fresh orange, 2 represents a rotten orange. Every minute. Okay, so they are talking about minutes, right? So, you know, you can convert hour to minute. At some places, it was about hours. Right. So every minute, a fresh orange that is four directional adjacent to the rotten orange become rotten. Right. So diagonal elements are not considered adjacent. Only. So if we have a rotten orange here, then only these four cells are considered to be adjacent. Right. So if a rotten orange is in cell IJ, then it will rot oranges in cell i minus 1j, i plus 1j, ij plus 1, ij minus 1. So it will rot oranges in these four cells only. All right. So we have to return the time after which all the elements in the matrix will rot. There is a possibility that let's say if we have a fresh orange here. So if you have a fresh orange here, then this fresh orange will never rot. So the total time to rot this entire matrix is in a way infinite, because you know the fresh orange is not reachable from any of the rotten oranges. So if this is the case, then we should be returning minus one, indicating that you know it is impossible to rot all the oranges in this matrix. I hope the question is clear, right? Saurabh? Is the question clear?
Yeah, it's clear.
All right. Have you done this question earlier?
No.
All right.
Archit raised hand. Archit, you want to ask something?
Yeah. So brute force, I was thinking you could iterate over
all the Rotten Tomatoes notes, and after each time step, you can actually mark all the tomato oranges that would get rotten, and you would proceed. But I was thinking a more optimized approach would be finding, I think, some way through connected components, like a graphical approach.
Okay. So is it about connected components? Because here, you know, maybe this is one connected component, right? This is another connected component, and this is another connected component. If you are thinking in terms of graph, right? So if you are thinking in terms of graph, then this is three connected components, right?
Yeah.
So I think more than connected components problem, it is a shortest distance problem, right? What we want to do is that we want to find the shortest distance of every fresh orange from a nearby rotten orange, right? So what is the distance of this cell from a nearby rotten orange? The distance is 1 hour or 1 minute, right? Let's stick with hour, you know, hour only, right? So the shortest distance of one, this fresh orange is just 1 hour. I'm measuring the distance in hour, just to indicate that, you know, this particular fresh orange will rot in 1 hour, right? So the shortest distance of this particular one from a nearby rotten orange will be 2 hours, right? Right? So let's say we have a two here, right? Then this particular fresh orange is 1 hour distance away from this rotten orange, and this fresh orange is 2 hours away from the other rotten orange, right? So we are looking for the shortest distance from the nearby, the most closest rotten orange. So for this particular orange, the answer is one. Does it make sense?
Yeah, but what if it's like an isolated fresh orange? Then it would never ever get rotten, right?
Yeah. So for isolated fresh orange, the shortest distance is actually infinite, right? And if we have an infinite time, so in that sense, okay, I got it. So this was where you were coming from. So that's why you said that, you know, we are looking for only connected components.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can think like that, you know, within the connected component, the main problem is that we are finding the shortest distance. Right. And there should be at least one rotten orange in each connected component.
Yeah. Yeah.
Otherwise that particular component will never be reachable. Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So either you can think in terms of the component as a whole, or you can think directly in terms of only one fresh orange, right? For every fresh orange, we are trying to find the shortest distance from a nearby rotten orange. And then we are returning the maximum of all of these distances. If the maximum distance is infinity, then we are returning minus one. You know what I mean, right?
Yes, yes.
Let's say somehow we are able to find the shortest distance. We'll see how to find the shortest distance. But let's say somehow we are able to find the shortest distances. Then the shortest distance for this particular one is 1 hour. The shortest distance for this particular one fresh orange is also 1 hour. The shortest distance for this one is also 1 hour. The shortest distance for this one is 2 hours. The shortest distance for this one is 2 hours. The shortest distance for this one is 1 hour. The shortest distance for this one is also 1 hour. Right? So we will be returning the maximum out of all of them, which is 2 hours, right? So the entire matrix will rot in 2 hours.
Kamal, I think it was in minutes, so we should not confuse the
question. Yeah. So initially I told in terms of hours. So, you know, now let's stick to hours, right?
Okay, sure.
Even though it is minutes. So we can just convert hour to minute. All right. For shortest distance, we just have a traversal algorithm, which is BFS. Breadth first search, right? So using BFS, we can find the shortest distance of all the nodes, right? Let's say you have A, B, C, D, and, you know, maybe E and F. So let's say the graph is like this. So let's say this is the graph, right? and maybe, you know, A and F are also connected, right? So if we apply BFS, taking A as the root node or the source node, then what will happen? How do you apply the BFS? First, we will store A in the queue, right? Right, Archit?
Yes, yes.
Right, then we will remove A, print A, and store all the nearby edges of A, all the adjacent edges of A. There are three edges which are adjacent to A, E, B, and F. So we will print B, F, and E, right? Let's say we are maintaining the distance. So if you are maintaining the distance, then A is at zero. So whenever we are inserting a new node, we will insert the distance of that node as distance of current node plus one. So the distance of B is one, distance of F is also one, distance of E is also one, right? Then you remove B, and for all the adjacent nodes of B, if they are not yet visited, we will insert them in the queue again, right? So B has three adjacent nodes. B has A, F, and C, right? A is already visited, F is already visited. Visited means that F is already inserted in the queue. C is the only node which is left. So we will insert C now. And the time for C will be, or the distance for C will be 2. Right? Which means that C is at a distance of 2 from A. Right? Then we remove F. Right? We print F. And so C is now inserted. So C will be visited. Right? So F has three adjacent nodes, A, B, and C. And all of these three nodes are visited. If all of these three nodes are visited, then we won't be considering any of these three nodes again. Okay? So then we remove the next node, E. E has only one adjacent node, which is A, and A is already visited, so we will not consider it. Then we remove the next node, C. C has one non-visited adjacent node, that is D. So we will insert D, and the distance of D will be 2 plus 1, that is 3, right? Now, if you notice that the distance of C from A, so you can go from C to A via this path also, via this path also, and you can go from C to A via this path also, right? So this red path is actually three edges long. Right, the distance of red path is 3, right? But still we say that the shortest distance from A to C is only 2, right? So using BFS, when we traverse a node, when we traverse a tree, we traverse the tree in a level order traversal. Level order means that first you print the nodes which are at distance 0, which means A, then you print the nodes which are at distance 1, which means F, B, and C. Then you print the nodes which are at distance 2, which means C. Then you print the nodes which are at distance 3, which is D, right? So practically, we are not considering this edge, right? We are considering only these edges. Does it make sense? Ajit?
Yes. Yes, yes.
All right. So we will be using a similar algorithm here. Just that instead of having one source, all of these rotten oranges will be a source. Right? So what we can do is that first you traverse the entire matrix, and then while traversing the matrix, wherever you find a rotten orange, just insert that rotten orange in a queue. Right? Let's say we have a queue.
Sorry for interrupting. Just a quick question. So we'll have to keep one queue for all the rotten oranges, right? Single queue.
We can maintain everything in one queue, right? You can have multiple queues, but you know, we are trying to apply BFS here in matrix, right? And this is for a very specific problem, right?
So
when you are applying that algorithm specifically for this, then you don't need multiple queues, right?
Right. So, but we'll have to update the minimum distance, because from one rotten tomato, it might be a farther distance.
Yeah. So initially we will traverse this matrix and find all the source nodes, right? So you are right that we will be having multiple source nodes. Here we have only one source node, that is A, right?
Yeah.
Here, all of these tools will be source nodes.
Right.
So let me just
it might happen, right, from a particular tool, a fresh tomato has a distance like 5, and we traverse it via BFS and we insert it into the queue as 5. But then when we visit it from another source node, the distance might be 2. But it is already visited, so we don't push that with distance 2. So we'll have to update it accordingly, right?
So let me put it this way. So let's just write the algorithm and then see whether we are able to handle that situation or whether we are not able to handle that situation, right?
All right.
So I understand your example. For example, this particular one. This particular one is reachable from this two also and from this two also. So what you are saying is, if we already updated with value 2, then will we be re-updating it with value 1, right? Right?
Right.
So what I am saying is that this question, this situation will never come with this particular group from this particular two first, right? So in this queue, hello?
Yeah.
Hello? All right. So in this queue, we are storing three things. We are storing I, J, and time, right? For each element in the queue, right? So you can say that queue element is something like this. So class queue element, and every queue element has one integer I, one integer J, and one integer time, right? So this is what every queue element will have, right? So we are creating a queue of queue elements, right? So let's just call it QE, right? So we are creating a queue of queue elements, QE, and let's say this is Q, right? For the sake of simplicity, let's say we have a Q class, and this Q class has, insert and remove function, right? So what we will do is that we will traverse the entire matrix for I is equal to 0, I is less than N, I plus plus, assuming that the matrix is N cross N. So for J is equal to I to N, for J is equal to 0 to N, for I is equal to 0 to N, we'll say if A of I, J is equal to 1, sorry, is equal to 2, which means that this particular element is rotten, then we say Q dot insert new Q element with value I, J, and time is 0, right? So we will go to each and every cell and we will see if there is a rotten orange in the cell, then we will insert that cell into the queue, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So first we will insert 0, 2, then we will insert 0, 4, because cell 04 is also rotten. Then we insert 21 because 21 is rotten. And then we insert 44 because 44 is also rotten. Time for all of them will be 0. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Right? Now what we are doing is that we will keep removing the elements. So remove the first element, right? 02, this element is removed. And then look for nearby fresh oranges. This element has a fresh orange here in the adjacent cell, right? So, and insert all the fresh oranges. So this will be 0, 1, and the time for this orange will be 1, right? And before inserting, let's make it 2. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Then we remove the next element, 04. 04 has an adjacent fresh orange, which is 14. So we will insert 14, and the time for this orange will be 1. right? We are going in a level wise order. First, we are considering all the nodes in level zero, right? Zero means all the cells which are rotting at time zero, which means that we are already rotten, given rotten, right? Then we will consider all the nodes which are rotting at time one. Then we will go to all the nodes which are rotting at time two. So we are going one level at a time, right? So next is 2-1. So we delete 2-1. Now this 2-1 node has two adjacent fresh oranges. So both of them will become 2, and we will insert both of them 2 into the queue. So one is 1-1 and second is 2-2. And both of them are rotting at time 1. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Right? Then we remove the next value, 0-4. So 0-4 is this value, right? So it has one fresh orange nearby, which is at 4-3. 4-3. So the time to rot is this, right? Now we have considered all the cells which are given to be rotten at time 0. And all the cells which will be rotting at time 1 are already in the queue. Right? So this is also 2. Right? Then you delete the next element, which is 0-1. So the nearby element, there is no nearby cell for 0-1, which is fresh. Right?
Right. So
this cell was there, become right?
Yeah, sorry. Go ahead. So while inserting in the queue, we are also updating the matrix having the position.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. We have to update the matrix. Otherwise, we will end up considering the same cell again.
Right.
So what I'm saying is that this way, whenever you are going to a fresh orange, you will first approach the fresh orange from a nearby rotten orange.
Yeah.
Right. So what you were saying that, you know, what if we have already updated it with value 5, and the minimum value is 1.
Yeah.
So that situation will not come. It will first be approached by 1.
Yeah.
Right? So if a rotten orange can reach that cell in 1 hour, then it will reach it in 1 hour first. Yeah. Right? And then the orange, which is 5 distance away, will come. But by the time that orange comes, which is 5 distance away, the value in this cell has already become 2, because, you know, this cell is already rotten. You know what I mean, right?
My God.
All right. So then 0-1 is removed. So 0-1, there is no nearby cell of 0-1, which is containing a fresh orange. Then 1-4 is removed. What is 1-4? 1-4. 1-4 also does not have any fresh orange, any nearby fresh orange. Then 1-1 is removed. 1-1 also does not have any nearby fresh orange. Then 2-2 is removed. So 2-2 has a fresh orange nearby, which is at 2-3. So we insert 2-3 with value 2. Right? All right. Then we remove this becomes 2. Right? So this becomes 2. Then we remove 4-3. So 4-3 is removed. And 4-3 also has a nearby orange, which is at 4-2. And the time to rot this will be 2. Right? And then we remove 2-3. Then we remove 4-2. Right? And so the maximum time to rot all the oranges is 2, right? So 2 will be our answer. But before returning 2, you have to traverse the matrix again to see if there is any fresh orange which is left, right? Let's say we have a fresh orange in this cell. Now this orange will remain fresh because this is not reachable from any of the rotten oranges, right? So after processing this, if there exists a cell with value 1, it means that that particular cell will always remain 1, right? So if a cell exists with value 1, then orange is in this matrix. Otherwise, we'll just return the maximum value. Does it make sense?
Yes.
Anyone else has a question? All right. Tapasya, you have any question?
No, I don't.
You got the solution, right?
Yes.
All right. So how much time are we taking here? How much time will this logic take?
N square.
So first we are traversing the entire matrix. So this time will be O n square. Then we are using this Q. This will also take n square. Right? Because in the worst case, we may end up going to each cell once. Right? And then we are traversing the matrix again to check if there is any leftover fresh orange. So that will also take n square time. So the total time taken is on the order of n square plus on the order of n square plus on the order of n square, which is also equal to on the order of n square. Right? So this is the total time taken. Right? This makes sense, right?
Yes.
So we can just write the code while Q dot is empty. So while the Q is not empty, right? What we will do is we'll say Q element temp is equal to Q dot remove. So remove from the queue and then insert all the nearby elements of this temp. So there are four nearby elements of temp, right? So temp.i and temp.j is the coordinates of the cell, right? So the four nearby elements will be temp i plus 1j, temp i minus 1j, temp I j plus 1 and temp I j minus 1. Right? So we have to consider these four elements, these four cells. Right? If any of these four cells is 1, then we will just insert that cell also in the queue. Right? So first of all, if temp is greater than 0, if temp dot I is greater than 0, then if A of this is equal to 1, then insert this. Then Q dot insert new Q element with value temp dot I plus 1, comma temp dot J. And the time for this will be temp dot t plus 1, right? To the other temp dot I is less than n minus 1, then this will be I. Sorry, if it is greater than, this should be less than, right? If this is less than n minus 1, then we are considering the next row. If this is greater than 0, then we are considering the previous column. Similarly, previous row, similarly, we'll be considering the next column and the previous column, right? So next column and previous column. This will be temp and this will also be dot j. So if temp dot j is then in one, so it should be as 1. Similarly, if this greater than 0, then insert, right? And this should also, this makes sense, right? The code, right? And every time we will keep a track of temp dot time, right? So this is the maximum time. Integer max time is equal to 0, right? And then we'll say max time is equal to temp dot t, and at the end we should just return this max time. Return max time, right? But before returning max time, we'll have to traverse the array once again and see if you know there is any leftover one, if any one is left in this matrix again after doing this, right? So if aij is equal to one, then we should just return minus one from here, right? I'm just removing these brackets just for the sake of simplicity, right? You should always have these brackets, right? So I'm removing this just to save some space. All right. So these are the three steps which we have here. All right. Any questions that you have? Get max time to rot. And let's say this array is given. N is also given. All right. Any questions that you have?
No.
No. All right. See, the important thing here is not whether we are able to solve this or not, right? Obviously, when you look at the solution, you will find the solution, right? You will be able to understand the solution. Plus, this particular problem is, you may find the solution of this particular problem in so many YouTube videos free of cost. Right. The thing is that whether you are able to apply this logic in a similar problem that you see during the interview or not. Right. During the interview, chances are that this particular problem is not asked. Right. Let's say this problem is not asked. Another problem is asked. That problem is also using the shortest distance logic. So if that problem is also using the shortest distance logic, then you should be able to, apply the logic of shortest distance in that problem also. You know what I mean, right? So if a person has done the BFS algorithm already, and if a person already knows the applications of BFS algorithm, which is to find the shortest distance, then that person should be able to come up with this particular logic, right? If we are not able to come up with this logic, it means that, we are not decoupling the logic from the problem, right? So there is one problem and there is a logic of that problem. The problem is, only one problem, but the logic of that problem may have applications in so many other problems which are not directly related to this problem, right? I think I'm confusing you guys, right?
No, completely agreed.
All right. So let me just reiterate. What I'm trying to say is that we have learned BFS when we learned BFS, which is very strongly connected with graph data structure. This problem is not even remotely connected with graph data structure, right? So we should be able to apply the algorithm in a problem which is not related to the problem that we have learned that algorithm in, right? So this is what, if you have to take one thing from all of these meetups, then this is the one thing that you should carry back home. That algorithms have their applicability outside the problems that we have seen. Similarly, data structures have their applicability outside the problems that we have seen. Essentially, whenever a problem comes, ultimately you will be choosing one data structure, one or more data structure, right? How you use those data structures and how you combine those algorithms and use it in a very, in a very problem specific way is what defines your problem solving abilities. Does it make sense?
Yes.
All right. So if you guys have any questions, I'll be happy to answer. Otherwise, I'll just hand it over to Vikas.
So first of all, people can share in the chat box. So how was your experience? You can type it out in the chat box. So we'll get to know that, how is this effort coming out? Yeah, so you guys like to chat. In the meantime, the people are typing in your responses in the chat box. Just to share that we do offer coding interview course, which is a 1-month program, system design course for senior developers. And then we also offer customized one-on-one coaching covering. So some people are looking for DP assistance. Some people are looking for some problems on lead code. So we have that. And in addition, placement assistance too. So it would be great if you can spread the message about these free workshops that we are having. And any one of you like to discuss any problem, you can share with us in advance. So we will send out an email to you so that you have all the information. So Anand just shared that it was his first session and it was very good. So thanks, Anand, that you liked the session. So purpose of these meetup is that it so happened that as a developer, we sometimes get so busy with in our office work that we forgot to brush up our ideas. It's only during the interview we realize that, okay, we should keep preparing for it. So even though even if you are not looking for any change in job, but still you can attend, join this weekly session so that you keep brushing up your ideas and know what is happening new. So another, Saurabh also shared this, Archit also great session, Avinash, mine too, I like the session. So thank you everyone. So these were the different services that we talked about. We will send out an email. You have all the details in email along with the phone number and email of Kamal so that you can talk to him. Is concept of bridges already covered?
Kamal? Not yet. So what we are doing every week is that we are picking one question and we are trying to not just look at the solution of the problem. We are trying to, you know, develop an approach to solve problems which are of similar nature, right? Right. So this is what we are trying to do every week, right? So, you know, it is just, this is our fourth meetup, I believe, right? Because?
Must be, yes.
Right. So this is just fourth meetup. In one meetup, we discuss dynamic programming problem. In one discuss one meetup, we discuss, you know, problem related to binary search, I think, right? So in every meetup, we just pick one, you know, medium to hard problem of lead code and we just try to solve that problem, right? Yeah, please go ahead, yes. Vikas.
Yeah, so definitely in case anybody has a particular query, so we will share the email and phone number of Kamal so you can directly talk to him also. And as he always says that it's not just for problem you should talk to him. As a teacher also, you can always talk to him. He's a great teacher within him. So you can always talk to him if you need any, if you have any query, you need any information. And in case you are looking for any placement related assistance also, you can get back to us.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, it'll be, I'll be happy if you just call me just to share your experience. Let's say you go ahead with a Google interview and, you know, these are the questions which were asked and this is how you have solved it, right? So that will help other students also. We'll pick those, you know, we'll pick one of those questions in the next meetup.
Yes. Right. Kamal, Anand asked that, is there any archive of previously discussed problems? So we have the notes all, at least, not the recording.
We have the notes. This is the first time that we are recording it, right? So going forward, we will have a recording of all of these meetups, right? But till now, we did not record these meetings.
Yes. So yes, we will definitely share, Amit, the OneNote link of the problem that we discussed today. So that, and also probably share it in PDF because sometime what we have in PDF stays with us, all these links and sometime get lost over a period of time. So we will share in the PDF format too, so that you can have that for your quick reference. I think that's all for today, Kamal.
Yeah. Thank you guys. Thanks a lot. Yeah. Thank you.